Yeah, well, obviously, it's a dream event. It's also nice to cement the club level. I think a few things have done in the last few years, and I think we've got to just keep nailing our associate preparation. I think if we can keep winning associate tournaments and stay on top of our game there, and keep pushing for that place, on the best level. But I think we've got to compete more against the likes of Zimbabwe and Bangladesh first on that level, and then before we make the step up, really.
Can I have a follow-up? How big a loss is losing Owen Morgan for the tournament?
Yeah, it's obviously massive. He's our best player, he's our best batter, but I'm delighted for him. I think it's great that he's got a chance to play for England, and I hope he has a long, successful career with England. He's made that decision now and made the step, and I think everyone in Ireland wishes him all the best.
Isn't that
going to
be the biggest hindrance to Ireland's progress?
Every time
you could use anybody who's pretty good, England
and Nicholas have the bad. Yeah, it's not easy, but I think it's all credit to Ireland. We're starting to produce cricketers like that, and I think the more we can do that, and the more we can progress and produce better players, the more help it's going to be to ourselves, progressing up the ladder towards Test cricket. So I think it's a good thing from that perspective.
You just got, as a fact of life,
Yeah, at the minute we're realistic over the next 5 to 10 years. We're going to struggle over the next 5 to get the test status, and anyone that's good enough to make that step up, I think it's the natural progression, really. So it's natural progression, really. Yeah, we thought we did, but obviously the way he's progressed and the way he's been playing recently, and they had a decent line start in the winter. They've obviously been impressed with what they've seen, and they also got 160 in one of the French Scotland games as on Sky. He's playing really well, and I think good luck to him. They've given him a chance, to take the chance now and put him in at the deep end, really. And hopefully he does well.
He's got a massive chance in the group he's landed with that.
Could possibly be correct. Yeah, we're looking at it that way, and I think you've got to look at it that way, no matter who's in the group. But yeah, I think we've got a realistic chance of qualifying, and yeah, we'll be ready for it.
If you could have chosen any group, you'd have
put the ones up. Yeah, obviously, Bangladesh are going to be our biggest game, really, because that's the game we're realistically looking at. We're keep going through. If we can win that game, it's a strong possibility of going through. We've also got India after that, but it gives us a chance.
You could probably tell us more about Holland than I know, anyway.
Yeah, I think if Dirk Nanez, you got a real chance. I think some of the balls 90 miles an hour plus is going to be easy for any batsman. Batsman this season, you've obviously got the likes of Ryan Tendiscala, who's a real true in the county level, and I think he's a real good, real class player. He's a massive boost to Holland, both with bat and ball. And I think with them two in your side, they're both match winners, no matter who you're playing against, those last good 30 games.
There are a few different praises from what you achieved in West Indies, the World Cup there, in the longer form one day game. Is that though what you achieved, a good launch pad, or do you start, because it's a T20, a completely different clean sheet?
I think after the last World Cup, and albeit 50 overs, I think any World Cup is coming up, and we obviously got to qualify. Qualifying's a must. I think that's where Ireland's got to start. And I think from qualifying, just before the season started here in South Africa for the 2011 World Cup, I think the funding that we're receiving now after qualification is going to stand out in great stead over the next 2-3 years. I think we've got two lads now in full-time contracts, which are the first two Irish players on full-time contracts back home. And I think that's the way we've got to go, is get lads into full-time, and I think we're going to progress from there. And playing full-time cricket is the way forward, and it's the only way we're going to improve and make it to test level. So, it's great. The more funding we can get, the more players will get on full-time contracts, the more we're going to progress in any form of the game.
You caught the imagination of everyone in Ireland, with your exploits in the West Indies. Is this another chance for you really to try and, put cricket on the map and get everyone watching back home too?
Yeah, it is, definitely. And I think after the last World Cup, speaking to a few people, there wasn't too many aware that we actually played cricket back home. But I think everyone has just progressed really from then. And I think over the last 2 years, the coverage in Ireland has improved dramatically. And I think this is another chance for us to showcase really what we can do. And if we can pull off another victory and another upset and make it into the Super 8, it's only going to help the game in Ireland.
Do you anticipate a pretty good home support?
Yeah, there's quite a few coming over, and I think especially when we're facing up in Trent Bridge as well. There'll be a lot of Asian community up there, so there'll be hopefully good crowds at the game and a lot of Irish coming over, so it's meant for a good atmosphere. I think it's the format of the game with a lot of associates are really kind of inexperienced and they haven't played a lot of 2020 cricket at this level, so I think we've got to use this and learn from it and obviously compete as well. But yeah, I think the more international cricket and the more cricket we play against the top nations, the better, and you can only improve if playing against the best.